Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial video of WebAppick channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to configure variable product price and quantity. And obviously, we'll be using CTX Feed, a WooCommerce product feed generator plugin as usual. So without further ado, let's start the video. So I'm at my WordPress website right now. So first of all, let's see what product we'll be dealing with today. We'll be working with fabrics which has an ID number 221. We'll be using this as an example later on. So let's go to the plugin CTX feed. Let's work with this test feed, and in the test feed you'll see these two options: variable product price and variable product quantity. The variable product price has three different options to choose from: first variation price, max variation price, min variation price. The first variation price will generate the first variation of the product, and max variation price will choose the maximum price of your variation product, and the min variation price will choose the minimum price of your variation product, and it will generate in your feed. And if you see the variable product quantity, it has four different options: first variation quantity, max variation quantity, min variation quantity, and sum of variation quantity. The first variation quantity will automatically generate the quantity amount of your first variation product. The max variation quantity will generate the maximum quantity of your variation product. Min variation quantity will generate the minimum, and the sum of variation quantity will generate all of your variation products addition. So it will add up all of your variation product and it will generate the summation of it. So let's look at an example to make it more understandable. Let's select variable product price to minimum. So I want my price to show minimum at the feed, and variable product quantity, I want my quantity to show the maximum amount. Let's just update and generate feed. Let's just go to this link to see the XML file. And before going to the XML file, what I want is I want to look at my product, what will be showing as an example. Let's go to fabric. And if you see the detail of fabric, the variation details, you'll see I have two different color options to choose from: black one and red one. You can see the black one has a regular price of $50 and it has a stock quantity of 20. And the red one has regular price of $60 and has a stock quantity of 30. According to my choosing option, I chose minimum price and maximum quantity. So it should generate, if I search with the product ID which was 221, you'll see the price is showing 50 USD. That means it is showing the minimum amount from the two variation, which was $60 and $50. So it's automatically showing the minimum price, which is $50. And if you look at the quantity, it's showing 30. That means I had two different quantity in my variation, 20 and 30. It's generating the maximum stock quantity, which is 30. Let's look at another example. What if I change the option? Now I want my variation price to show maximum variation price. That means it should generate the maximum amount, which is $60. And variation product quantity, I want sum of variation quantity. Now let's just generate the feed. And now if you look at the XML file and search for the product ID, you'll see it's showing the price to $60. That means it is taking the maximum price. And if you search for the quantity, it's showing 50. So the quantity was 20 and 30. It's adding both of the quantity and showing the addition of it, which is 50. So this is how you can configure variable product price and quantity. And this feature is available only at the pro version of CTX Feed. That's all for today's tutorial video. Thank you for watching.